What's up, everybody? A Sparrow with a Gun here from Sleepless Nights with another episode on Subnautica. When we left off in the last episode, we actually got our moon pool going, which is pretty cool. And we found out about, let me see if I can get it right. Little baby bladderfish. There, I almost got it. Little baby bladderfish. There we go. Which is right there. I don't know why that's so fun for me to say. I just really enjoy it. But it also confirmed that we can basically grow our own food. Oh, I thought this guy was in here, and I was like, wait, how did a boomerang fish get in there? That was weird. Alright, so yeah, this honestly, to me, I'm not 100% sure, but having just an aquarium of, or excuse me, an alien habitat, because we changed the name of it for some stupid reason, having that of just bladderfish and peepers, I think is probably the easiest food source, because bladderfish, if you get at least three, maybe two, you're probably fine for water unless you're super dehydrated. And peepers, I mean, literally one or two cooked ones, you can go from like starving to full. So I honestly think we probably can cut down on trying to do like a ton of, basically like food farms and tree farms and all this kind of, like, honestly, we can kind of just do that and be done. I am going to, let's at least grab this. Oh, okay. Can I get another one out of it? Oh, wow. Okay. I was thinking that wouldn't work. Oh, I didn't mean to eat it. Dagnabbit. Well, okay. I wanted to refill that because, apparently, there we go. So you can get five samples out of one plant, which is cool, and then we'll just put one of the seeds back. I honestly should have, in hindsight, gotten all of the seeds off of it first, because I could have at least made lubricants or rubber or something, so that's my bad. I just wasn't thinking about it. It's not like we don't have creep vine to work with, so we're good. So in the last episode, I blundered and made everything that I needed in order to make the the Cyclops upgrade. And these chests and stuff have devolved, or lockers have devolved just into random storage crap at this point. They're not really doing the whatever they're supposed to. But I made what I needed to do the Cyclops Ultra Compensator upgrade thingy-mobobber. Yes, that is the official name. And then I realized I did not have a modification station, which is what you actually need to build the dang thing. So, yeah. That said, I really need, I could also make a vehicle modification station for the sea moth, but at the moment, I'd kind of like to go over to, I think the closest is over in the mountain biome. It's also, there's also a wreck in the Grand Reef, or no, you can get it on the Grand Reef floor. There is no wreck. I don't know, maybe we should...
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
Maybe we should go to the Grand Reef. No, because I'm thinking what we found last episode was if you already scanned the fragments, so once we get what we need, we can just keep scanning all the fragments in the wreck and make some easy titanium. This door thing, bubble, whatever, is still there even after I took out the vending machine. So, yeah, I'm thinking that's just some kind of bug from when I parked it somewhere. I must have parked it somewhere, and I really think it's been ever since I went to one of the mountain areas, and I think honestly a mountain got stuck in the what should have, like, position data type thing, it got stuck in here, and then because it was not actually there, it let me move, and then it doesn't know what to do with it because the game thinks there's something there. That's what I think's going on. I don't really know. But we're gonna run over to the mountain biome, I think, and look for the wreck over there, and see if we can't find our modification station, which then leads to our pressure upgrade thingy-majigger. So, and then I might work on gathering the remaining components that I need to make a vehicle modification station to upgrade the sea moth as well. Okay, so as you might have noticed, we're not really in the mountain area, are we? We're kind of in the Grand Reef. So what basically happened was I was on my way to the mountain area. Something decided it wanted to lag up my game. Don't know what. And then it stayed in such a state of not loading for a long enough time. I think it timed out kind of thing. Because my whole entire game just crashed. And I was like, okay, well, that's lovely. Detecting titanium mass somewhere in the same, unable to confirm whether it originated from the Aurora. Really? Is there a wreck down all the way down here? That would be interesting. So anyways, I decided to reassess where I wanted to go. And in doing so, I actually found that I was actually much, much closer to the Grand Reef than I was to the mountain area. So, with that said, I decided to come here. Now, the only problem with coming here is, as far as I'm aware, which basically means it was this way on the wiki, because that's pretty much all where I get my information from, if it's not from comments from other videos and so on and so forth. Purple pine cone. What is that? Salt deposit. That's one of those weird warper spider things or something, I think. I actually have not seen much of them in action. 30 seconds. But that makes me interested, though, with the whole detecting titanium thing. So the thing is, it's not part
Welcome
of a wreck
aboard, Captain.
Or anything.
All systems online.
Yes, I heard you. Thank you. The man, I don't know why my frames are so low in here, though. That's unfortunate. Because up until now, we haven't been having too many frame rate problems. But I'm starting to get... Maybe it's just a lot of terrain loading or something is doing it. I'm not sure. But it's definitely having some struggles in this area. I need, like, a really deep submersible, not submarine, because sometimes maneuvering this ship through here can be kind of... taxing. But anyways, the problem with the Grand Reef has been that, as far as I know, the modification station fragments are just, like, on the ocean floor somewhere. There's no...
Posse safe death.
So creepy. I don't think there's any, like, wreck or anything that just happens to... Whoa! What is that wraith-looking thing? What the heck is it? Okay, we're leaving. I don't know what this place is. It scares me. No, actually, I'm leaving because I don't think I can go any lower, and I'm really not finding the fragments anywhere. Which has me wondering if they're really here, or if something's changed, or what. But yeah, that's the problem. The other one at the mountain area was supposedly in a wreck. But like I said, I was headed that way, and my game crashed, so I decided to go another way because it was closer. But, assuming the wiki's correct... Oh, there's the base! That's right, I did find a base down here before. Yeah, you and your safe depth. Alright, so we definitely want to explore that. Maybe that's something that will come out of this. I don't know why I'm down to like 10 frames, though. This is bad. Again, we've had hit-or-miss frame rate issues with Subnautica before. I honestly thought they had fixed some of that stuff. Ow! Jeez, that didn't waste any time coming after me, did it? Whatever that was probably that big crab-looking thing. Is there anything in here? I honestly forgot what's in here. There's a PDA. Degassi voice log.
New PDA data.
There's a coffee machine. That's right, somebody told me that this, along with the trash can, the coffee machine does something now, too. Those are much bigger up close, by the way. And very creepy. Maybe that's what's causing my frame rate problems, all their transparency stuff and whatever. I don't know. I honestly don't know, because we really haven't had too many problems with it since we restarted. I've been trying not to go super ridiculously crazy with my base building for that very reason, to keep the frame rate more stable. Miscellaneous. Coffee vending machine, 2 titanium, which ironically we don't have. So, I tell you what. While I would like to explore this a bit more, it said ocean floor. Alright, I need to get out of here, I think. Is the problem. Or one of my problems. Is I need to get out of here. And I seem to be stuck on something, which is kind of status quo for this game. I'm always stuck on something when I'm driving around my submarine. And I have lost my sense of direction, and I don't really know which way is out anymore. I think it's that way. But yeah, I was hoping that we could find the fragments, but I haven't honestly seen any. Like, I haven't even gotten out to scan any or anything and then just didn't get the right ones. I haven't really seen any fragments. So it's leading me to wonder if I've either got the wrong idea, wrong location, or if something in the data has changed. Which, actually, all of those could be possible. Because when I went through here, this area where it's more like less of the floaty orbs and more of just like the ocean kind of thing, I don't think that's how I'm supposed to go. But I could have totally just missed them entirely. But I really haven't been seeing any fragments laying on the ocean floor, like, at all. Let alone being the quote-unquote right one that we're looking for. I'm just not finding any. And that could just be me not seeing them, or it could be that something's changed and the fragments aren't spawning here anymore. I really don't know. So, with that said, we will probably try and head to another location that, according to the wiki, says it should be there and see what we can come up with. Seems like the best option. Okay, so I have good news and I have bad news. Good news is we're in the... oh geez, where are we? Blood kelp zone or something, I think. What the heck is that thing? What are these things? There's not supposed to be these things. Oh man, in the... oh wait, we already have that, but that's fine. Okay, what do I do against this guy, though? I mean, I don't think I can stasis grab it. Man, my frames are so awful right now. I think it's mostly pop-in loading, I think, that's hurting it, to be honest. I don't really know for sure, but that's what my gut tells me. Because it's always around areas when I'm just getting there or just starting to move around. Then it seems to... wait, why am I moving so slow? Is that what that thing does when it hits you? Does it slow you down? Or am I just seeing things? Maybe I'm just seeing things. I don't know. Okay, there's another one. Nuclear reactor. I don't think we have that one. Unfortunately, the bad news, what I started to say before I was interrupted by that little floaty warpy guy, is that we're running low on... oh, there it is. We're running low on water.
30 seconds.
And air. I mean, air's a problem too. Especially since I wasn't smart enough to bring my Seamoth with me. Though, I don't know that it would have actually reached this point either. I probably should angle my ship and bring it down a little bit more.
Oxygen.
We're running things a little close, aren't we? 13% water.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
No air.
All systems online.
Alright, so let's see if we can't... let's pull forward a bit and get our tail lined up there, and we should be able to drop down without any super duper incidents, and that'll keep us a little bit closer. But we gotta hurry this up because I have 11% water and I didn't bring anything with me food wise I got excited and just kind of ran off like I always do. And, completely forgot to bring any supplies with me. So, you know. Do I have... No, I don't. Okay, I was gonna say, I don't think I have a nuclear fragment yet.
Emergency. Severe dehydration.
Yeah, detected. I know.
Seek fluid intake immediately.
I know. I'm basically just hoping I can hold out long enough to get my scans. And then get back. Can I open this? That looks like an openable door, but it's not letting me. Are you seriously gonna make me look for one fragment? There we go. Last piece of the puzzle. And actually, last piece of the puzzle with this one, I think. Alright. There may be more, but I really don't have the resources to go exploring right now. I really need to get back. So, we have what we need for the modification station as far as blueprints. Now I need to actually double check and make sure I can build it, which is another task in and of itself. But the bigger, more immediate problem is going to be getting back to the base before I dehydrate to death, basically. I think we can do it because you don't seem to lose too much while piloting the sub and stuff like that. You usually aren't running low on a lot of that stuff, but I have honestly no idea how this is going to go. I guess, worst case scenario, I could grab some surface fish and just eat them and stuff, but if I can make it back, that's probably more ideal. So we're gonna see. So this is something new I've never really encountered before. I don't know what happens when you hit zero on your hydration. So we just hit zero. I don't know if you start losing health, if you just die.
Warning, dehydration level critical. Metabolic processes disrupted.
Well, there you go. So we took about 14% or something, rough math. 12% maybe. If we drop to 20, it's 12. The next hit. Okay, so it was 14. So you take like a 14% hit every couple of seconds, and I'm probably going to get back here and die because I don't think I have any water already set up type of thing. And wait for it. Wait, I have zero health now. Oh, there we go. I was gonna say I have zero health now, but I'm still walking around. Okay, so we are back not dead after that, but I did find an interesting one of the PDAs that we picked up. I wonder if this was added later, since the bio update or whatever it was called, the infection update, because this is talking about them being sick, the Degassi survivors, that it was like, we're sick. You've been coughing, feeling itchy, the suit biometrics would have warned us, it's something new, stuff like that. And they basically didn't know what was going on or if there was a cure or a fix or anything like that. So that's an interesting setup. We also got the... Wait, I have uranium. Oh, uraninite crystals, that's right. So we have that. I want to make this coffee machine too, because I'd kind of like to know what it does. Just for kicks and giggles. I don't think I have the silver to make the wiring kit and everything. Oh, it goes on the side, okay. So what do you do?
You look like you could use some coffee.
Oh my gosh, that's hilarious! You look like you could use some coffee! That's so funny. Okay. Oh, there it goes. Mm-hmm. There's no cup, but, you know. H2O4. Okay, and then what does this give me? 3 and 2. So, theoretically, I mean, this takes forever, mind you. But in theory, as long as you had one of these going and one of these going, you actually would be okay with food, because for every snack you had that dropped you by 2 but raised 3 food, you could have a coffee, which gives you 4. So 40 and 80. And we're at 43 and 82. So I think that's like bare minimum, you know, emergency food supply kind of thing. But realistically, I think this is going to work out much, much better. What do we have? Lots of peepers, but we have four... Now, wait a minute. Wait just a minute. I've scanned peepers before. Oh, now this is interesting. I've scanned peepers. You can see that it doesn't have a scan, but that infected one lets me scan again, and it says infected. Interesting. I don't know that I want to grab that. I might not want to eat him. All right, so I, like I said, I always want to make sure I leave at least two of the... of each kind, really, in there. And at some point, I'll get off my lazy butt and actually make a fabricator that's not part of this guy up here in the little life pod. But, meh, you know. Uranium is 3, and of course I picked up 2. Of course I didn't get enough. So overall, as long as we don't leave the base, I think we're pretty good on food, because between the peeper and, peeper and bladderfish spawning kind of thing, and then the vending machines and the coffee machines, I think we should be fine on food. I think that almost negates the need for, like, the hanging tree farms and stuff like I had before, because basically this is going to give us what we need, and then in emergencies you could use the other one and still be fine. Unfortunately, though, I don't think I have any silver, which I'm going to need at least like 3 of in order to make this work. Pretty sure if I did my math right anyway, that's what we're looking at. But that's an ion crystal. There's diamonds. There's all that. So yeah, I don't think I have any silver. So what we're going to need... We already have what we need to actually make the compensator, but for the modification station, we have 2 titanium. We need a wiring kit, which I'm pretty sure is just 2 silver, and then a computer chip is 1 quartz, 1 silver, and 2 coral. So all of that's not that hard to make. I just have to gather the silver, so I need like 3. And then for the... What did I need for the vehicle system upgrade thingy? Here we go. Glass we have 1 of. 2 computer chips would be a total of 5 silver and 2 titanium. So overall I need about like 5 silver and we should be okay. Alrighty, so I think I've got everything that I need. Yes, I know I'm hurting. I had a couple of close encounters with a few stalkers, which did not end well for me, as you can tell. Let's see, and the other thing that I need is I know I need a glass piece, so let me just double check real quick now that I'm out here in the water. So that's 1 computer chip and a wiring kit, and this is 2 computer chips and the glass. So that should be easy enough. Wiring kit and 3 computer chips, I believe. If I did my math right, we should have enough to do that. Please tell me I did my math right. I did! Huzzah! Hooray. Okay. That said, let's get on down here. Nope, get out of there. And let's go ahead and put the mod station just for now. This is kind of a little bit of a cramped base at the moment, but I'm not super worried about it. So we'll put you right there. And then, let's see, we could put it there? We could put it there. I'm kind of thinking there, actually. That works for me. A boom. All right. So, now we have, again, the torpedo systems, the prawn suit stuff, the sea moth, And then common modules, which is the pressure compensator. There should be upgrades to that, or is that through the... That might be through the mod station, now that I think about it. We have hardened blade. Ooh, we can make a diamond one. Now, the only thing I don't know is I don't know if I should make a diamond blade after I've already made a fresh knife, so it's got higher durability. Not really sure. There's our ultra compensator. And then the CMOD. There we go. The Mark II and the Mark III. Okay. So, the last piece to today's puzzle is to take the pressure compensator.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
And add it to... Whoa! Online. Hold up. This changed directions now. That's funky. I used to have to go around this way. Now it's the other way. Okay, so I really don't know what that's about. Really have no idea. Wait a minute. Hold on. Stop lagging. What the heck? That's weird. 82.0. I put a fresh power cell in here somewhere. What? That's weird. Man, I don't know what is going on with my frames right now. I mean, I'm in like the safe shallows. I shouldn't be really doing anything taxing. But when I walk back here, I get like 10 to 15 frames and that's it. That's really weird. I don't know what that's about. Okay, so we have the compensator. That's the part that makes me think that it's not really like a you can't run the game type thing, like most people's maybe, because my frame rate dips and stuff are not consistent. They're, in fact, very inconsistent in that one minute I'm getting like, you know, normal, regular, solid frame rate, and then the next minute it'll drop to like 5, and then it goes back. So it's just kind of weird. What? I'm a knucklehead. That's a power efficiency upgrade. Alright. This has been quite the project for me, because it always seems like I never can get this done. Like, I never can seem to get what I need to get. So, I was a dum-dum and thought that I had the first-tier pressure compensator, and in fact, all I ever had was the power efficiency upgrade. I have, in fact, never had the pressure compensator, which requires a plasteel ingot. I don't think I have any extra lithium, which means I can make the main pressure compensator, but I don't think I can make, unless I have an extra lithium lying around, which I don't think I do. I may have enough titanium already, I just don't think I have any extra lithium. First time in forever that it wasn't stalker teeth that I was missing, but lithium. Yep, no lithium. No lithium. Alright. Well, that just means that between now and the next episode, I need to get a piece of lithium and make sure I have enough titanium to make the... whatchamacallit? Another plasteel ingot. Wait, where do I make this from? Is it in the fabricator? I'm a little confused. Not going to lie. Because if I just do the blueprints, rearrange the submarine's hull, blah blah blah, that's fine, but where do I... Is that in the maybe the vehicle mod station? Or the mobile vehicle bay? I'm not really sure where that is. It's not in the fabricator. That's just the Ultra. This is interesting. I don't recall running into this before. I don't know where you make that from. It has a recipe. That's... Wait a minute, that's really odd. Hold on. Where's my... The last thing that I'm gonna try is my mobile vehicle bay. Because without that, we checked the fabricator and I didn't see a blueprint there for it. We checked the mod station. I don't know where you make this. Wait a minute. Is this one of those where I have to put a... This might be one of those where I have to put a fabricator on the Cyclops, isn't it? I'm thinking that's what I gotta do. What is a fabricator anyway? Wiring kit, computer chip. Of course, I just used all the silver to make the other stuff. Alright, great. Another blunder. Another episode of progress foiled by my own stupidity. Okay, so I'm pretty sure. Let me know in the comments just before I mess something else up. But I'm pretty sure the only way for me to get that is to take a fabricator and put the fabricator on the Cyclops, which then lets me build a standard upgrade. And then once I do that, I can bring that back to the mod station with another plasteel ingot to compensate for what I use. And then that will give me what I need to do the ultra. I think that's right, but let me know in the comments if I'm barking up the wrong tree or not. But overall, I mean, we did make progress. We got the mod station finally, we got the vehicle upgrade station finally, so that's all well and good. But as far as what I wanted to really get done, I didn't really get that far. And actually, we got the nuclear reactor upgrade as well, though we didn't build it, but we can if we want to now. And we did some tests with coffee and snacks. So let me know what you guys think about all that in the comments, and double check my plan and make sure that I don't do something stupid again. And in the meantime, we're gonna wrap things up here. I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and I will see you all next time. Peace.